Shankaracharya, Ashtatara Sata Sri Srimad, His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada Ki, ISKCON Founder Acharya, Srila Prabhupada Ki, Nitya Lila Pravishta Om Vishnupad, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Thakur, Srila Prabhupada Ki, Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda Ki, Nam Acharya, Srila Haridas Thakur Ki, Primshiko Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nichananda, Sri Advaita Vaita Kedarhar, Sri Vasati Gaur Bhakta Vindaki, Sri Sri Radha Krishna Gopa Gopinath Shyama Kund Radha Kund Giri Govardhan Ki, Vrindavan Maya Purdam Ki, Ganga Mai Yamuna Mai Ki, Tosi Maharani Bhakti Devi Ki, Yuga Dharma Harinam Sankirtan Ki, all glories to all glories to Assembled Devotees, all glories to Assembled Devotees, all glories to Sri Guru, Sri Gauranga, all glories to Srila Prabhupada, Nama Om Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale, Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namane, Namaste Sarasati Devi, Gauravani Pracharine, Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshataya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 Narayanam Namaskrityam.
Narayanam Namaskrityam.
Naram Chaiva Narottamam.
Naram Chaiva Narottamam.
Devim Sarasatim Vyasam.
Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam.
Tato Jayamudiraya.
Tato Jayam Udiraye.
Nashta Prayeshu Vabhadreshu.
Nashta Prayeshu Vabhadreshu.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya.
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke.
Bhagavati Uttama Shloke.
Bhakti Bhavati Naistiki.
Bhakti Bhavati Naistiki.
So I think most of you are familiar with the first two cantos of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
我想你们绝大多数人对于Srimad-Bhagavatam的前两篇都非常的熟悉。
The first two cantos of the Srimad Bhagavatam are called the Padapadma, meaning the lotus feet.
Srimad-Bhagavatam的前两篇被称为是Padapadma，也就是莲花足。
Because the different cantos, we know in Srimad Bhagavatam there are 12 cantos, so the different cantos are compared to different bodily limbs of the Lord.
我们知道Srimad-Bhagavatam有不同的篇，每一篇都被比喻为是主 Krishna 主的他的不同的身体的部分。And
the 10th canto is the face of the Lord.
而第十篇是主的脸。Before
we look on the face of the Lord, we should first of all look to his lotus feet.
在我们看主的脸之前，我们应该先看他的莲花足。And
Srila Prabhupada in purports throughout Srimad Bhagavatam stresses the importance of understanding very clearly the first two cantos of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
Srila Prabhupada 在整个Srimad-Bhagavatam通篇都非常的强调，应该着重理解 Srimad Bhagavatam头两篇的内容。
In other words, Srila Prabhupada wanted us to study the Srimad Bhagavatam systematically.
换句话说,
from the beginning.
Srila Prabhupada 想让我们非常有系统的从一开始学习 Srimad Bhagavatam.
At the same time, Prabhupada also said, wherever you eat, the Srimad Bhagavatam is like sugar candy, sugar cane. He said, wherever you chew the sugar cane, it's sweet. So wherever you read Srimad Bhagavatam, it's pleasurable and purifying.
学了泡泡说，睡梦八卦他们就好像是甘蔗一样，无论你从哪个地方开始吃，都是非常甜美的，所以可以从任何的一个地方你去读，都会觉得非常的甘美。
But if we read it in a systematic manner from the beginning, we will get a deeper understanding of the progression.
但如果我们从一开始以一种非常有系统的方法去读 Srimad Bhagavatam, 我们就可以得到一种循序渐进的理解。
When Srila Prabhupada came to America, he brought with him his three volumes, which were the first canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
当舍罗帕帕德去美国的时候，他随身携带了《施曼巴格塔姆》的前三卷。
And then, while he was in America, he was translating the second canto. And as he translated, they were publishing one chapter at a time.
在美国，舍罗帕帕在翻译《施曼巴格塔姆》的第二篇，而且呢，他每翻译完一章，大家就同时出版一章。
So.The different chapters were there in separate volumes. But then it was understood better to put them together in one volume.
因此不同的章节在以不同的卷本得以出版，但是我们知道最好呢，为了大家的理解，还是把它们全都合成一卷。
So the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam is connected to the first canto. It's important to understand the connection. Just like in Bhagavad Gita, there's connections between the different chapters of the Bhagavad Gita. In the same way, there are connections between the cantos of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
我们要知道 Srimad Bhagavatam 的第二篇跟第一篇是有关联的，就像是在 Bhagavad Gita 之中，每一章之间也有互相的关联。因此，我们重要的是要理解到，在 Srimad Bhagavatam 之中，每一个篇章之间它们的连接是什么。
First canto was Sutta Goswami speaking, replying to the sages of Naimisharanya.
第一篇是 Sutta Goswami 在讲话，他在回答 Naimisharanya 森林之中的圣人们的问题。
And you don't hear from Sutta Goswami again until the 12th canto.
然后直到第十二篇为止，你再也听不到 Sutta Goswami 讲话了。
And then the 12th canto, for about 5 chapters, Sutta Goswami is speaking.
在第十二篇之中，大概其有五章的篇幅是 Sutta Goswami 在讲。
So the first canto is, we see the preparation for the appearance of Sukadeva Goswami.
第一篇我们可以把它当成是一种为了 Sukadeva Goswami 显现的一种准备。
We have the sages of Naimisharanya inquiring from Sutta Goswami, and Sutta Goswami replying to them.
有 Naimisharanya 森林之中的圣哲询问 Sutta Goswami, 以及 Sutta Goswami 对他们的回答。
And then you have, then you hear about how the Srimad Bhagavatam came to be spoken.
然后我们听到 Srimad Bhagavatam 是如何被讲述的。
And we hear about Narada Muni instructing Srila Vyasadeva.
而且我们听到 Srila Narada Muni 在教导 Srila Vyasadeva.
And then we hear about the departure of the different great personalities. First of all, there's the departure of Grandfather Bhishma.
接着我们听到如何那些伟大的人物相继的隐迹。首先我们听到的是伟大的祖父 Bhishma。
And then there's Dhritarashtra leaving home and going to the forest, and he gives up his body there in the forest.
然后又 Dhritarashtra 离开家庭，然后他去了森林，在森林里离开躯体。
And then after Bhishma and Dhritarashtra, then you have the annihilation of the Yadu dynasty.
在 Bhishma 以及 Dhritarashtra 之后，讲的是整个亚度王朝的毁灭。
And with the Yadu dynasty all destroyed, after that, then Lord Krishna also disappears from the world.
在整个的亚度王朝被毁灭之后，主 Krishna 也从这个世界上离开了。
And then, after Lord Krishna disappears from the world.Then the Pandavas also decide it's time for them to leave the world, and they go off to the Himalayas.
当 主 Krishna 离开这个世界之后，潘德瓦们他们也决定应该隐迹，所以他们全都去了喜马拉雅山。
And with the departure of the Pandavas, he enthroned Maharaj Parikshit as the ruler.
在潘德瓦兄弟隐迹之前，他们设立 Maharaj Parikshit 为统治者。
And then Maharaj Parikshit, after ruling for some time, he is cursed by the son of the Brahmana, by the son of Samikarishi, is cursed.
在 Parikshit Maharaj 被设立为统治者之后，他统治了一段时间，然后受到了一个 Brahmana 叫做 Samika Rishi 他的儿子 Sringi 诅咒了他。
So with the cursing of Maharaj Parikshit, he gives up the kingdom, takes off all of his royal ornaments, and leaves the palace, and he goes off to find someone to guide him and help him to prepare for his departure from the world.
当 Parikshit Maharaj 受到诅咒的时候，他放弃了自己的王国，放弃了所有的皇室的这些装饰品，他离开家去外面找一个人能够指导他，为自己离开躯体，离开这个世界做好准备。
And that's when Sukadeva Goswami appears.
就在那个时候 ，Sukadeva Goswami 显现了。
And with the appearance of Sukadeva Goswami, all of the sages who were present, many sages had gathered, many great personalities had all come because they knew it was going to be the departure of Maharaj Parikshit. So many great sages all appeared.
伴随着 Sukadeva Goswami 的显现，有很多的伟大的圣人们都来了，因为他们知道这个是 Parikshit Maharaj 要离开躯体了。
And Parikshit Maharaj was actually the ruler of the world at the time.
在当时 Parikshit Maharaj 其实他是整个全世界的统治者。
And he was the grandson of Arjuna, so he was a very respected personality.
而且他是 Arjuna 的孙子，因此呢，他是一位非常受尊敬的人物。
So great souls all appeared, but when Sukadeva Goswami appeared,they all understood that Sukadeva Goswami is the one most qualified to guide Parikshit Maharaj.
当 Sukadeva Goswami 显现的时候，大家都公认 Sukadeva Goswami 是最有资格指导 Maharaj Parikshit 的人。
So many other sages were there, and they all had different ideas about or different opinions about what Maharaj Parikshit needs to do to prepare to leave the world.
在场有很多伟大的圣人，他们都有不同的意见，关于 Parikshit Maharaj 应该如何为自己离开这个世界做准备。
But with Sukadeva Goswami appearing, they all gave him the right, the chance. They said, he is the son of Vyas, let him speak. He is already situated on the transcendental platform.He's the most qualified person to guide.
但是当 Sukadeva Goswami 显现的时候，大家一致公认应该选举他，他是最有权力的，最有资格来指导 Parikshit Maharaj 如何去离开躯体，离开这个世界。
They had never met before.
他是 Vyasadeva 的儿子，但是以前他们从来没有见过面。
But they have some things in common.
但是他们有一件事情是共同的。
The main thing which they have in common is that they are both devotees.Of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
他们两者之间的最重要的共同点是都是主 Krishna 的奉献者。
But their backgrounds are very different. Maharaj Parikshit is coming from the royal family.
但是他们的背景非常不同。Maharaj Parikshit 来自于皇室家庭。
And there's Sukadeva Goswami. He's coming from Vyasadeva, the son of Vyasadeva. They've been living in the cave in the mountains somewhere.
但是 Sukadeva Goswami 他是 Vyasadeva 的儿子，他们一直住在山洞里。
Very, very renounced and detached from the world.
非常非常的气绝，非常的不依附这个世界。
He is Atmarama.
他是 Atmarama.
Meaning one who takes pleasure in the self.
意思是一个在自我之中得到满足的人，得到快乐的人。
We take pleasure in eating and sleeping.We take pleasure in the things of the material world.
我们是从吃睡这些方面得到快乐，我们是从物质世界之中得到快乐的。
But Sukadeva Goswami, he takes pleasure in the self.
但是 Shukadeva Goswami 是在自我之中得到快乐的。
He's a fully transcendental realized soul.
他是完全的超然的一个灵魂，已经觉悟了自我的灵魂。
So he has appeared to, he's given a chance to guide Maharaj Parikshit. And Maharaj Parikshit has a question he wants to ask. He wants to know that what is the duty of a person who is about to die?
Shukadeva Goswami 显现之后，他得到了机会可以指导 Parikshit Maharaj。 而 Parikshit Maharaj 有一个问题，那便是如果一个要死的人，他的职责是什么？
And what is the duty of all people at all time?
而且对于所有的人而言，一直以来他们应该有什么样的职责？
And what should they hear, chant, and remember and worship?
他们应该聆听什么，唱诵什么，意念什么，崇拜什么？
What should they not do?
他们不应该做什么？
Important to know.
了解这一切是非常重要的。
What should we do and what should we not do?
我们到底应该做什么，应该不做什么。
So the second canto begins with Sukadeva Goswami instructing Maharaj Parikshit and replying to this question.
因此第二篇开篇便是 Sukadeva Goswami 在回答 Maharaj Parikshit 这个问题。
And Sukadeva Goswami glorifies Maharaj Parikshit. Your question is very glorious. He said this is for the benefit of the whole world.
Sukadeva Goswami 在荣耀 Maharaj Parikshit, 你的这些问题是非常有荣耀的，因为可以给全世界带来好处。
The whole world needs to hear the answer to this question. It will be beneficial for them.
全世界都应该聆听对这些问题的回答，这将对大家都有好处。
And Sukadeva Goswami goes on to describe the nature of materialistic life.
Sukadeva Goswami 接着继续描述关于物质主义生活的情况。
He says, materialistic people have many subject matters for hearing and chanting.
他说物质主义者们有很多的题旨去聆听并且去唱诵。
We see the birds in the trees.They're always hearing and chanting their own topics.
我们可以听到，也可以看到，在这里树上的鸟儿们，它们总是有自己的主题可以去聆听、去唱诵。
And in the night, we'll hear the jackals. They have their topics for hearing and chanting.
在晚上的时候，我们可以听到豺，它们也有自己聆听和唱诵的主题。
Everyone's busy. Questions and answers.
每一个人都忙着提问回答。
But their questions and answers are not in relation to the absolute truth.
但是他们的问题跟绝对真理无关。
Sukadeva Goswami says, Apashyatam atmatattvam greheshu grehamedinam. Apashyatam atmatattvam means they don't inquire.Materialistic people never inquire about the absolute truth.
Sukadeva Goswami 说，那些物质主义者从来不去探寻绝对真理。
They will ask, "How much money do we have in the bank today?"
他们会问，今天咱们在银行里还有多少钱？
They will ask like that, "How much have we spent? How much have we earned?"
他们总会问，咱们花了多少钱？挣了多少钱？
We'll ask, what's the weather like today? Is the sun shining or not?
今天天气怎么样？有没有阳光啊什么的？
But they will never ask about the absolute truth.
但他们永远不会询问绝对真理。
They will never ask, please tell me something about Lord Krishna.
他们永远不会问，给我讲一讲关于 Krishna。
Where is Krishna? When will he come?
Krishna 在哪儿？他什么时候会来？
So Sukadeva Goswami says, Greheshu.Grihamedinam, that there are two types of grihastas.
So Sukadeva Goswami 说 Griheshu Grihamedinam, 有两种类型的 grihasta.
Right, there's a grihasta who is in the grihasta ashram, which is a spiritual position.
有 grihasta, 他们处在 grihasta ashram 之中，这是一种灵性的地位。
And there are grihamedis.
而且还有 grihamedi 们。
Grihamedi means, medi means envious.
Grihamedi 里这个 medi 的意思是嫉妒的。
Right, the, in materialistic life, people are all envious of each other.
在物质主义的生活之中，人们彼此互相嫉妒。
We'll look at the next door neighbor to see what are they doing.
我们看隔壁的邻居，他们家在干什么。
Oh, they got a new refrigerator.
他们家买了一个新的冰箱。
Our refrigerator is still old. They've got a new one.
我们家的冰箱都已经旧了，他们居然买了个新的。
Oh, they got another child. I've only got one.
他们家又生了一个孩子，我才一个孩子。
They've got two.
他们有两个。
I need another one.
我也需要另外的一个。
Like the, this is the Graham Mady, the thinking of the Graham Mady life.
就像这样，他们是 Graham Mady, 他们是活在 Graham Mady 的生活之中。
Very envious.
非常的嫉妒其他的人。
And they spend their whole day. How do they spend their whole time? They spend their whole time concerned about two things: money and sex.
他们整天怎么过日子呢？他们整天都想着两件事情，那便是金钱还有性。
They work very hard to make money.
他们非常努力的工作去挣钱。
They're thinking how to invest the money to get more.
他们想着怎么去投资，然后才能挣更多的钱。
So many people do that, right? They have, they get the offer. If you give your money to me, I'll give you big interest. You just give the money to me, and I'll give you a lot of money back in interest.
有很多的人现在做这个，他们说你把你的钱给我，然后呢，我就会给你很多的利息。
People are tempted.
然后人们受到了诱惑，我可以挣更多的钱。
So this is a materialistic life. We're thinking, how much do I have today? How can I get more tomorrow?
这便是物质主义的生活。我在想着今天我有多少钱，明天我怎么能够挣更多的钱。
So the whole day is spent working to make money. One job is not enough. One job in the day, another job in the night, another job on the weekend.
这样呢，整天都忙着工作赚钱，白天打一份工，晚上打一份工，然后周末的时候再打一份工。
And as soon as there's a job with more money, okay, that's it. A new job. I'm going to go to this job. I've got more money.
一旦有另外的一份工作可以让你挣更多的钱，你就立刻想着，我要去干这个新的工作，我可以赚更多的钱。
We're always thinking about our material gain.
我们总是想着自己的物质得意。
This is the business of the Graham Mady.
这便是 Graham Mady 的生活。
Why does he want more money?
为什么想要更多的钱呢？
Thinking, I will enjoy more my life. I will live comfortably.
然后他就会想，我可以更多的享受，我的生活会变得更加舒适。
I will get a nice apartment.
我可以得到一个非常好的公寓。
And I will decorate it with luxury furniture.
我可以用非常豪华的家具来装饰它。
And I'll get a nice water bed for myself to sleep on.
而且我要给自己来一张非常好的水床，好好的睡觉。
And I will have a nice queen for me to enjoy with.
而且我还要娶一个特别好的王后跟我好好享受。然后我生很多的孩子。他们全都会服务我。崇拜我。给我极大的爱和情感。这样我会永远的生活下去。他们从来没有想过终于有一天我会死。
The Graham Mady, his whole business is just to enjoy the body.
Graham Mady, 他们的所有的活动都是说为了享受这个躯体。
Money.
金钱。
And then sex.
然后是性。
Satisfy the senses.
满足感官。
Sex is not only gross, subtle sex also.
这种性呢，并不仅仅是这种粗糙的方面，而且还有精微的性欲。
Profit, adoration, and distinction.
那便意味着一个人去追求别人的仰慕、利润，别人的仰慕、利益，还有别人的尊敬。
Sukadeva Goswami was describing this to Maharaj Pariksit, because Maharaj Pariksit has to prepare for death.
Sukadeva Goswami 把这一切都描述给了 Maharaj Pariksit, 因为 Maharaj Pariksit 必须要为死亡做准备。
He has a short time,
它只有很短的时间，七天。
But we don't know how many days we have.
但是我们并不知道我们有多少天。
Every day we hear this person died, another person died.
每天我们都听到这个人死了，那个人死了。
Everybody else, we're all waiting. We're all in the line waiting to leave the world.
其实我们都在等待，我们都排着队等着离开这个世界。
But who's thinking I'm going to leave the world?
但是谁想到了我要离开这个世界呢？
We're all thinking, I will live forever. I'm going to stay long. I have a long time. I'm still young. I'm not ready to die.
我们都是想着，哦，我会永远的生活下去，我还很年轻的，我还且死不了呢。
But we don't know what is the plan of Krishna.
但是我们并不知道 Krishna 的计划是什么。
We have to be ready at any moment to leave the world.
我们必须要做好准备，在任何时刻离开这个世界。
So Sukadeva Goswami was encouraging Maharaj Parikshit, don't feel that you've lost something.
因此 ，Sukadeva Goswami 在鼓励 Maharaj Parikshit。不要认为你失去了什么。
Don't regret this opportunity which you've been given.
不要为你被赐予的这种情况而感觉到后悔。
Maharaj Parikshit may be thinking, "Oh, I should live longer. I should be the king longer. Why I need to die now? Let me try to avoid death."
Maharaj Parikshit.可能他在想，为什么我现在要死呢？可能我需要更长的活，更久一点，或者是我可以当国王，当得更久一点，
But、
我可以去避免死亡。
Maharaj Parikshit just accepts. Okay, yeah, I did wrong. I committed offense against that brahmana. His son cursed me. It's my fault. I deserve it.
但是 Maharaj Parikshit 他接受了所有的一切，这是我的错误。那个 brahmana 的儿子诅咒了我，我接受，这是我的。缺陷错误。
So he gave up everything, and he's now he's getting instruction from Sukadeva Goswami.
他放弃了一切，现在他得到 Sukadeva Goswami 的教导。
And Sukadeva Goswami is telling him what he needs to do to prepare to leave this world.
而 Sukadeva Goswami 在教导他，为了离开这个世界，他应该做什么样的准备。
And it's important that Maharaj Parikshit.Doesn't keep any material desires in his heart.
重要的是 ，Maharaj Parikshit 不应该在内心之中保留任何物质的愿望。
He may be thinking, you know, maybe I can get a better life in the higher planet.
可能他会想着，也许我可以在更高等的星球得到更好的生活。
Because the Vedas do offer life on the higher planets. Go to heaven and enjoy there.
因为伟大经典的确是给人提供这种更高等的星球的生活，你可以去那个地方享受。
And there are people who do regular fire sacrifices with their motive is that they will go to the heavenly planet.
有人经常做火祭，他们的动机是为了能够达到更高等的星球。
So going to the higher planets is aIt can appear attractive that there's a longer life there, and there's more sense gratification.
去高等的星球看起来非常的有吸引力，因为在那个地方可以生活的更长，而且有更多的感官享乐。
Oh, the women are very beautiful there.
在那个地方的女人们都非常的美丽。
Oh, the men are all handsome and strong.
而且男人们都非常的强壮，非常的英俊。
And you can enjoy sense gratification for a long time.
你可以很长时间享受感官的满足。
You don't have to worry about pregnancy until you get near to the time when you give up the body.
除非你到了该离开躯体的时刻，否则的话不用担心怀孕的问题。
So people may be attracted. Go to heaven and enjoy there.
因此，人们可能会受到吸引，去天堂，在那个地方享受。
But Maharaj Parikshit, or Sukadeva Goswami rather, he wants to encourage Maharaj Parikshit, don't be attracted to go to the heavenly planet.
但是 Sukadeva Goswami 他在鼓励 Maharaj Parikshit 不要受到吸引去天堂星球。
Don't be thinking about sense gratification anywhere in this material world.
不要去想着这个物质世界之内任何地方的感官享乐。
You should be convinced that this whole material world is just a miserable place.
你应该坚定地确信，整个的这个物质世界是一个非常痛苦的地方。
Even you go all the way up to Brahma Loka, even Lord Brahma has to worry about giving up his body.
甚至你一直去 Brahma Loka, 连 Brahma 他都要担心，终于有一天他会放弃自己的躯体。
So be convinced that you want to go, you want to reach the supreme destination. You want to go beyond the coverings of the universe.Into the spiritual sky.
你应该让自己坚信，要达到灵性的最高的目标，应该穿透这个物质宇宙的覆盖层，要达到灵性天空。
So, Maharaj Parikshit is told by Sukadeva, he said, "It is a procedure which you have to go through to prepare yourself."
Sukadeva Goswami 告诉 Maharaj Parikshit， 到底为了让你自己做好准备，应该采取一些什么样的步骤？
And he encourages him. He said, "You have to leave home, get out from the house, don't stay at home."
而且他鼓励他，你应该离开家，不应该待在家里，你应该出去。
Because at the time of leaving the body, if you're surrounded by your family members.And then the affection will be very strong.
因为如果在离开躯体的时候，你身边环绕着都是自己的亲戚的话，那么这种感情是非常强烈的。
The poor man will be thinking, "Oh, my wife, who will take care for my wife and my children? Who is going to take care of them if I'm leaving the world?"
这个可怜的男人就会想着，哦。我的可怜的妻子，谁来照顾她？当我离开这个世界的时候，谁管我的妻子？谁来照顾我的孩子？
So it's important before the time of death, you have to get out from the home, leave these people, because these people are not the shelter. They're not the real shelter to save us from birth and death.
重要的是在离开躯体之前应该离开这些人，因为这些人并不是拯救我们摆脱生死的庇护。
If we take shelter of the family members, they are called fallible soldiers.
如果我们要是脱避于自己的家庭成员的话，他们被称为是一定会犯错误的士兵。
Fallible soldiers mean they're not going to win. They're not going to help you defeat the will of birth and death.
一定会犯错误的士兵，这个意思就是说，他们不会帮助我们打赢这场仗，他们不会帮助我们征服生与死。
We'll, if we leave the body, seeing our dear wife, we'll come back the next life.
We'll come
back in the same home, the same family, or somewhere we'll get some connection.
如果我们在死亡的时候看着我们自己的妻子，那样下一世我们还要再来，再次回到同一个家庭之中，无论如何就是跟这个家还有关系。
At least this is how it's described in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
至少
Sukadeva Goswami instructing Maharaj Parikshit.
至少这个是 Srimad Bhagavatam 之中的教导，当时是 Sukadeva Goswami 在教导 Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami sGoing to describe a progression in self-realization.
Sukadev Goswami 将要描述的是一种循序渐进的自我觉悟的程序。
We know from the first canto, Sutta Goswami had already described how the absolute truth is Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan.
在 Srimad Bhagavatam 第一篇之中，我们了解到 Sutta Goswami 已经描述了绝对真理是。Brahman, Paramatma, 还有 Bhagavan.
Vedanti tat tatvam vidam tatvam yajnanam abhayam. Brahmeti paramatmeti Bhagavan iti shabdyate. Sutta Goswami says, learned transcendentalists who know the absolute truth call this non-dual substance as.Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan.
Sutta Goswami 是这样描述的，他说那些渊博的超然主义者把这种非二元性的实质描述为 Brahman, Paramatma, 还有 Bhagavan.
Three levels. They're all the absolute truth. Brahman is the absolute truth. Paramatma is the absolute truth. Bhagavan is the absolute truth. Different ways of seeing the absolute truth.
三个层面全都是绝对真理，Brahman 是绝对真理，Paramatma 是绝对真理，Bhagavan 也是绝对真理，他们全是绝对真理。
Seeing the absolute truth as Brahman means seeing the energy of the Lord everywhere.
看到绝对真理是 Brahman， 这就意味着看到主的能量无所不在。
Something we call it pantheism.
有的时候我们管这个叫泛神论。
Right, that you see God in the world. The whole world is the manifestation of God.
你看到神，你看到全世界全都是神的一种展示。
So there is one way of understanding the Brahman.
这是一种理解 Brahman 的方式。
Then Paramatma, the understanding how the Lord is in the heart of all living entities.
然后是 Paramatma 理解到主如何处在每一个生物体的内心之中。
And then Bhagavan.
然后是 Bhagavan.
The personal feature of the Lord, who is residing in his own abode, and who appears in so many different forms in this material world.
那是主的人格特征，他住在自己的居所之内，但是呢，他也在这个物质世界之内展示很多的形象。
So Sukadeva Goswami begins to speak to Maharaj Parikshit about.The first level of realization, which is understanding the Brahman potency.
Shukadeva Goswami 向 Parikshit Maharaj 先讲述了理解的第一个层面，也就是主的 Brahman 的力量。
That he tells him to visualize the Virata Rup, the universal form of the Lord.
他让他构想一下 Virata Rup, 也就是主的宇宙形体。
Now Maharaj Parikshit, he's a devotee.
Maharaj Parikshit 他是一位奉献者
He's not an impersonalist.
他并不是一位非人格主义者
But Sukadeva Goswami is guiding him from the very beginning.
但是 Sukadeva Goswami 是从一开始指导他的
Yeah, we have to understand that when Sukadeva Goswami is speaking, there are many other people present and they're not all devotees.
我们必须要了解到，当 Sukadeva Goswami 讲话的时候，在场还有许多其他的人，而他们不是所有的人都是奉献者。
Sukadeva Goswami and Maharaj Parikshit, they're devotees, but there's a lot of others there, great sages and so on, and they're not always so attached to the personal feature of the Lord. They may be more inclined towards the impersonal aspect.
Sukadeva Goswami 和 Maharaj Parikshit.他们两个人是奉献者，但是当时在场还有很多其他的人，他们不是奉献者，而且他们很可能非常依附于主的非人格的特征。
So Maharaj Parikshit and Sukadeva Goswami, they're considerate souls, and they're speaking from the very beginning of the path of self-realization.
Sukadeva Goswami 还有 Maharaj Parikshit, 他们是非常思想周虑的人，他们考虑到其他人的好处，所以呢，就从一开始去讲。
Not everyone can appreciate the worship of the Lord as in the deity form.
不是每一个人都能够欣赏以主的神像形体显现的这种崇拜。
Some people say, "Oh, you're." Sometimes the Christians even accuse that we are worshiping idols.
有的时候，基督徒们就会谴责我们，你们崇拜的都是偶像。
Okay, the deity is not an idol.
但当然，神像并不是偶像。
But they don't understand the deity.
他们不了解神像。
And there are many other people who cannot understand how the Lord can appear in the deity form.
而且还有很多其他的人，他们并不能够明白主如何能够以神像的形象显现。
The form of the deity is called Archavigraha.
神像的形体被称为是 Archavigraha.
And the Lord actually manifests himself within that form of the deity.
主让自己显现在神像的形体之中。主这样做是为了取悦他的奉献者们。
But not everyone is able to understand this, and not everyone's willing to see the Lord in this way.
但并不是每一个人都能够理解这一点，也不是每一个人都愿意以这种方式去看主。
It's difficult for materialistic people.
对于物质主义者而言，这是很困难的。
Because they're very material, the more materialistic a person is, the more they're covered, and the harder it is for them to visualize the transcendental potency or transcendental features of the Lord.
因为一个人越物质主义的话，他们便越会受到覆盖，所以他便很难看到主的超然的这种特征。我们知道有一些人甚至不能够容忍我们唱诵 Hare Krishna， 他们会唱诵 Om， 他们不会唱诵 Hare Krishna， 因为他们已经对于 Hare Krishna 有一些固有的观念，他们觉得这个不是宗教的，他们觉得唱诵 Om 不是宗教的，唱诵 Hare Krishna 是一种宗教。跟物质主义者打交道的时候，我们也要对他们的情感非常的敏感，看看他们能够接受什么，他们不能够接受什么。
So, worshipping the deity is not really the beginning of self-realization.
崇拜神像并不是说自我觉悟的开始。
You want to bring people onto the path of self-realization, then it's recommended that they should try to contemplate the Lord in the form of the Virata Rupa.
如果你要是想让人们走上自我觉悟之途的话，你可以让他们先去尝试着去构想主的 Virata Rupa。
All the different features of the world in relation to a body of the Supreme Lord.
看到这个世界上不同的特征都跟主至尊主的身体的一部分有关联。
Just like the sun is compared to like the eye of the body of the Lord.
就像是太阳，太阳被比作是主身上的一只眼睛。
Because without the sun, cannot see anything.
因为如果没有太阳，什么都看不到。
I was talking with one of the devotees in Russia, and they were telling me how one of their friends is living in the very northern part of Russia, and the very northern part of Russia is very close to the North Pole. So in the winter time, they have all darkness.
我曾经跟俄罗斯的一位奉献者交谈，他告诉我说他有一个朋友住在俄罗斯很北的地方，那个地方很接近北极，因此在冬天的时候呢，整个冬天都是黑暗的。
And in the summer, it's like 24 hours sunlight.
在夏天的时候，一天二十四小时都充满了阳光。
So, they live, people live in these kind of conditions.
所以有人就住在这样的情况之中。
And of course, very cold.
当然了，很冷。
Anyway, the sun is not visible in some places. We're more fortunate here. It's more nearer to the equator, so you get a good amount of sunlight.
无论如何，有的地方看不到阳光，而我们在这个地方很幸运，因为我们离赤道很近，所以我们可以得到很多的阳光。
So the sun is like the eye of the Lord.
太阳就好像是主的眼睛一样。
And then the moon is compared to the mind, because the moon influences our mind.
月亮被比喻为是心意，因为月亮会影响我们的心意。
And then the rivers.Like we have the Ganga here and the Yamuna, they're compared to veins in the body.
而河流，我们在这里有恒河，这个就比喻为是主的躯体之内的血脉。
And trees, we see quite a few trees around here. The trees are like hair on the body of the Lord.
而树木，我们在这里可以看到很多的树木，这个被比喻为是主身上的毛发。
And clouds, just like today, there's a lot of clouds.Clouds are like the hair on the head of the Lord.
而云彩就像今天我们可以看到很多的云彩，这个被比喻为是主头上的头发。
And then we see in nature, we see so many different birds. Like staying here in Mayapur, you can see many different birds. You know, some of them are very colorful.
在自然之中，我们可以看到很多鸟类，就像在马耶普，我们可以看到很多的鸟，它们有一些是颜色五彩缤纷的。
So the birds, they represent something of the artistic nature of the Supreme Lord.
而这些鸟类便代表着至尊主的充满了艺术性的方面。
So the idea is to see everything in relation to the body of the Supreme.
概念是说，看到所有的一切都跟至尊者的躯体有关。
And there are different planets in the universe. There are 14 different levels of planets in the universe.
在宇宙之中有不同的星球，据描述说，在宇宙之中有14个不同的星球体系。
So at the bottom you have planets like Patala Loka, and they're considered like the legs and the feet of the Lord.
在底部有 Patala Loka, 这就被比喻为认为是主的脚。
We know that Bali Maharaj, when he got the kingdom taken away from him, he got sent to reside in one of the planets at the bottom of the universe.
我们知道巴利马哈拉吉当王国被从他那里被剥夺走了之后呢，他便被送到了宇宙的底部，住在其中的一个星球上。
Was it Sutala Loka?
Sutala Loka.
Sutala Loka.
在 Sutala Loka 上。
And the Lord is there with Bali Maharaj. They're residing in one of these lower planets called Sutala Loka.
而主也去了那里，跟巴利马哈拉吉一起住在 Sutala Loka.
But very dark in these planets. There's no sunlight.
在这些星球上是非常黑暗的，没有阳光。
They're below the earth.
他们在地球之下。
And they don't get sunlight. So how do they get light?
他们得不到阳光，那他们怎么得到光明呢？
Just I was asking this Russian devotee that what do they do there if they have 6 months of darkness? He said, "Oh, they just put lights everywhere."
我就问这个俄罗斯的奉献者，那如果你们有六个月的时间都是黑暗，那你们怎么办呢？然后他说，我们就在所有的地方都点上灯。
But in Srimad Bhagavatam, we're told that in like Sutala Loka, where these people are residing, where the demons reside, they use jewels for light.
而我们在睡梦的巴国他们之中可以发现，在低等的星球苏塔拉洛卡这个地方呢，那些恶魔们用珠宝来进行照明。
They have many different jewels which are reflect, which show, which provide light for everything.
他们有很多的珠宝，这个可以会给他们提供光明。
Even in the palace at Hastinapur, when the Pandavas were residing there, they had jewels to light the palace. They didn't use.Lamps, of course, no electricity, and oil. Oil is crude, you know. Well, if you have jewels, why not just put jewels there? No need to burn oil.
在 Hastinapur 的宫殿里，他们也是在用珠宝来进行照明，因为他们不点灯，当时他们也没有电，他们也不去烧这个油，因为用油是很粗糙的。如果你有珠宝的话，那为什么不就是放一个珠宝就有光明了呢？
So these lower planets, they're like.The feet and the legs of the Lord.
这些低等星球就好比是主的脚，还有主的腿。
And then the earth is somewhere in the waist of the Lord.
而地球是在主的腰部。
And above earth, then you've got Bhuval Loka, and then you've got Swarga Loka. Swarga Loka means heaven. And then above heaven, there's four more planets.
而在地球之上呢，先有 Bhuva Loka， 然后是 Svarga Loka。Svarga Loka 就是天堂，在 Svarga Loka 天堂之上还有四个星球。
有 Maha Loka、Jana Loka、Tapa Loka， and then Satya Loka。
有 Maha Loka、Jana Loka、Tapa Loka， 还有 Satya Loka。
Satya Loka that's the planet of Lord Brahma。
Satya Loka 是主 Brahma 的星球。
Right on the top of the universe。
就在宇宙的最顶部。
And then one of the planets, Mahaloka, is where Bhrigu Muni is staying.
有一个星球 Mahaloka， 这个是 Bhrigu Muni 住的地方。
And Tapaloka, four Kumaras are there.
在 Tapaloka 有 Kumar 四兄弟。
And so many others also, many other people are also there.
当然了，还有许多其他的人也住在那里。
Great sages like nine Yogendras, they're also there.
伟大的圣人就像是九位 Yogendra， 他们也都住在那里。
That's above heaven, above Swarga Loka. These four planets are there.
这个是在天堂之上，在 Swarga Loka 之上还有四个星球。
One of the Mahaloka, they're doing yagya and they're offering, they're doing different fire yagyas. And And Lord Vishnu is personally appearing and accepting their offerings.
在 Mahaloka， 大家在做祭祀，他们为火供奉不同的祭品，然后主 Vishnu 亲自显现，接受他们的供奉。
And on Tapaloka， Tapaloka where the four Kumars are， they're all meditating， they're all sitting in samadhi， they just sit in trance all day in samadhi meditating on the supreme Lord。
在 Tapaloka， Kumars 兄弟他们整天都坐在那儿冥想，他们在冥想至尊主。
And as you go higher in the universe to the different planets, the body becomes more and more subtle.
在宇宙之中，如果你去的这个地方越高，你会发现那个地方的人的躯体越精微。
We have the gross body. We have like a body with earth as well as, of course, there's quite a bit of water also in our bodies, but there's also earth, the bones and so on. It's the earth element.
我们的这个躯体是很粗糙的躯体，我们这个躯体里有很多的土，当然也有很多的水，但是比如说我们的骨头什么的，这些都是土构成的，土的元素。
But as you go up to these higher planets, up all the way up to Brahmaloka, the body becomes subtle. You just have the subtle body.
但是当你一路升到，比如说到了这个 Brahmaloka 的时候，你只有精微的躯体。
That's nice, huh?
那挺好的吧，不用照顾粗糙躯体了。哎，真是缓解了一大块。
But still, you have that. You still have the body. You still have the ego is there.
但仍然你还是有一个躯体，还有这种自我。
And we have to also get rid of that before we can go back to Godhead.
在我们回归守神之前，我们应该把这个也去掉。
So seeing these different.Planets in relation to the body of the Lord is purifying for us.
那么看到所有不同的星球跟主权都有关系，对我们而言是一种净化。
It helps us to understand that there's some person behind this world.
这会帮助我们在这个世界上，在所有一切的背后有一个人。
Of course, we don't want to become impersonalists.
当然了，我们不想成为非人格主义者。
The mood of contemplating the universal form is to be the, to give service.
冥想宇宙形体的目的是为了去做服务。
We have to develop the service attitude.
我们必须要发展出一种服务的态度。
Understanding our insignificant position, we should think, I'm not the master, I'm not the controller, I'm a servant, a tiny servant.
了解到我们自己微不足道的地位，我们应该明白到我自己不是主人，我自己是一个仆人，而且是非常微不足道的微小的仆人。
And this is really the mission of our Krishna consciousness movement.
而这真正的就是我们的 Krishna 知觉使命的这种目的。
We talk sometimes we hear about the service industry. You know, there's a manufacturing industry which is, you know, producing different goods.But there's also the service industry.
我们听说过服务行业，因为我们有时候听过这种工业行业。
Service industry, things like the hairdressers, you know.
服务行业，比如说理发的。
You go to the hairdressers, or you go to the beauty parlor, or whatever people do, you know, to take care of the body. You go to the gym.And these things, you know, this is all part of the service industry.
你去找理发师，你去美容院，你去这个健身房，这些全都是属于服务行业。
So we are also service industry.
我们也是一个服务行业。
Krishna consciousness is service industry.
Krishna 知觉是一种服务行业。
But the difference is everybody is giving service for the body and the senses.We're thinking about service to Krishna.
但区别就在于每一个人想的都是如何的去服务我们的躯体和感官，而我们提供的服务是服务 Krishna.
We want to give service to Krishna. That's the real goal of life.
我们想把服务给 Krishna， 这是生命的真正的目标。
So we were speaking. There's the Grihastha and the Grihamedi.
所以我们提到了有 Grihastha， 还有 Grihamedi.
Grihamedi, they don't think about self-realization.
Grihamedi 们，他们不会想到自我觉悟。
Apashyatam admatarvam. They will never inquire about the absolute truth.
他们永远不会去探寻绝对真理。
They'll never try to understand what is good for the people of the world.
他们永远不会想到对这个世界上的人们而言什么是有好处的。
They're only thinking what's good for me。
他们总是想着什么对我有好处。
What's in it for me? What am I going to get?
什么对我有好处？我能够得到什么
？That's the selfishness of the Graham Medi。
那便是 Graham Medi 的自私。
So Graham Medi, they stay in the material world. They're not going to go back to God.
所以 Graham Medi 们，他们住在物质世界之内，他们没有办法去回归守神。
But that is Grihastha. Grihastha means who are in the ashram for spiritual advancement.
但是有 Grihastha 他们住在这种灵性的 ashram 之中，取得灵性的进步。
It's not that all householders are in Maya.
不是说所有的居士都处在 Maya 之中。
There are so many great devotees who are in the family life.
有很多伟大的奉献者们也过着家庭生活。
And they show how to progress.In the spiritual consciousness.
他们表现出如何在灵性的知觉之中去取得进步。
Just like there's the Mahajans, and from the 12 Mahajans, maybe more than half of the Mahajans are in family life.
就像 Mahajan 们，一共有十二位 Mahajan， 而其中有一半的人，他们都是来自于家庭生活的人。
So we have to know how to make the best use of everything.
我们必须要了解到如何充分地利用所有的一切。
Just like we have this human body,
就像我们有这个人类的躯体。
We have to make the best use of this human body.
我们要尽最大的努力去充分利用这个躯体。
Make the best use of every moment in this body.
要充分地利用这个躯体所拥有的每时每刻。
Maharaj Gatvanga only had a moment, but he was able to get success.
Maharaj Katvanga 只有片刻的时间，但是他取得了成功。
We don't know how long we have in this material world.
我们并不知道在这个物质世界之中我们还能够停留多久。
But we want to try to make the best use.
但是我们想努力能够充分地利用每时每刻。
Krishna consciousness is in everyone's heart.
Krishna 知觉处在每一个人的内心之中。
It has to be awakened.
必须要被唤醒。
We have to hear carefully.
我们必须要认真地聆听。
We have to hear about Krishna.
我们必须要聆听 Krishna.
Right? Sukadeva Goswami describes to Maharaj Pariksit that if we don't hear the glories of the Lord, then our ears are like the holes of the snake.
Sukadeva Goswami 向 Maharaj Pariksit 描述说，如果我们不去聆听 Krishna 的荣耀的话，我们的耳朵就好像是蛇洞一样。
The snake enters into the ears. The snake of death enters our ears if we don't hear the glories of Krishna.
死亡之蛇就会进入到我们的耳朵之中，如果我们不去聆听 Krishna 的荣耀的话。
If our head doesn't bow before Krishna, even though you have a nice crown on your head,Are you decorated with a nice turban? If we don't use our head to bow before Krishna, then it is just a heavy burden.
如果我们不用自己的头去顶拜 Krishna 的话，尽管我们的头上可能戴着很华丽的王冠或者是非常华丽的头巾，但是我们不用自己头去顶拜 Krishna， 这个头就仅仅的是一种负担。
Sukadeva Goswami talks about how he said.Why do the great sages ruin their spiritual life by going to wealthy people to just praise them?
Sukadeva Goswami 解释说，那些伟大的灵性主义者为什么要毁了自己的灵性生活，去找那些富裕的人去赞美他们？
Go and see the rich people, glorify them. Oh, you're such a good man. You're so pious. And in this way, we hope we will enjoy the luxury of the rich man.
去找那些非常富有的人，然后呢，去赞美他们，荣耀他们。哦，你太伟大了，等等。然后这样呢，就是希望能够享受到他们提供的那些奢侈的生活。
Prabhupada never liked to flatter people.
Prabhupada 从来不喜欢去奉承别人。
There was this one rich man, and he had made a lot of money because he was mining oil.
有一个富有的人，他挣了很多的钱，因为他是，采油的。
So the devotees were telling Prabhupada, "We want to go and preach to this man."
奉献者告诉 Prabhupada， 我们想去给这个人去布道。
So Prabhupada said, "Oh, really? What are you going to preach to him?"
泡帕说，哦，真的？你想跟他讲什么呢？
So one devotee said, "Prabhupada, you tell him to surrender to Krishna."
有一个奉献者说 ，Prabhupada， 我们要告诉他应该臣服 Krishna。
Prabhupada laughed. He said, "Do you think he's ready to surrender to Krishna?"
Prabhupada 笑了。你觉得你以为他已经准备好了臣服于 Krishna 吗
？Then another devotee said, "Prabhupada, you tell him he's not the body."
然后另外一个奉献者说呢 ，Prabhupada， 我们要告诉他你不是这个躯体。
And Prabhupada said, "Will he believe you?"
然后 Prabhupada 说他会相信你吗
？And then Prabhupada looked at the devotees and said, "You should tell him he is a thief, and at time of death, Krishna will."
Prabhupada 看着这些奉献者们说：“你们应该告诉他，他是一个贼，在他死亡的时候 ，Krishna 会惩罚他。”
That he has stolen all the property of Lord Krishna, and at the time of death, he will have to suffer for all of his stealing.
他的财产都是从 Krishna 那里偷来的，在他死亡的时候，他将会因为自己的偷盗而遭受痛苦。
And so we see other people, you know, they would go to rich men, they would just simply flatter them, oh, you're such a good man, you're so pious, you have such good karma, you are enjoying, and we'll glorify them, and we'll say, can you give me donations?
我们可以看到其他的人，他们去找一些富有的人，然后就开始去奉承他们。哎呀，您是一个非常伟大的人，是一个非常虔诚的人，这样说完了一番荣耀的话之后，就说能不能给我点捐款？
But,Sukadeva Goswami said, "This is not. You shouldn't do that. This is not good. Don't ruin your spiritual life by just going to flatter these kind of people."
但是 Sukadeva Goswami 说呢，你不应该做这样的事情。你不应该通过去这样的人那里去奉承他们而毁灭你自己的灵性生活。
Sukadeva Goswami says, "The trees, they live a long time."
舒克德维格斯瓦米说：“树木，他们可以活很长的时间。
What is the value of a long life?
有很长的生命有什么用处呢
？The better a moment of full conscious.
最好还是片刻的完全的知觉。
The belt, he said, just because you're breathing, he said that is no great thing. The bellow, you know, the bellows, they're also pumping air.” But if you're breathing and you're pumping, the bellows are pumping air, you're also breathing. What's the difference between you and the bellows?
仅仅是在呼吸，这并不是一件什么了不起的事情。风箱也在呼吸。如果风箱在呼吸，你也在呼吸，那你跟风箱之间有什么区别呢
？So Sukadeva Goswami wants to awaken Maharaj Parikshit and all of us to the importance of self-realization.
舒克德维格斯瓦米想去唤醒马哈拉扎普里克希特，还有我们所有的人认识到自我觉悟的重要性。
Foolish people, they praise other people who are just like hogs, dogs, camels, and asses.
一些愚蠢的人，他们会赞美其他的傻瓜，而他们就好像是猪、狗、骆驼，还有 I forgot the last， 还有驴。
Hogs.The pig.
猪
they eat everything.
他们什么都吃
They don't care who they mate with. They'll mate with their own daughters.
他们不在乎自己跟谁交配，他们甚至跟自己的女儿一起交配。
So people, some people live like pigs.
有的人他们过得就像猪一样。
Very dirty.
非常肮脏。
No cleanliness.
不洁净。
No principles.
没有原则。
Very lazy.
很懒惰。
And then.Dogs.
然后还有狗。
The dog mentality. Prabhupada said that people go like dogs. They beg, "My dear sir, please give me a job. I will work for you. I will be a good dog."
狗的心态，说了Prabhupada说，我们去找工作，然后跟人家说，请给我一份工作吧。我可以成为一条好狗，我可以好好干活。
You go to college, study, get a degree, and then after you graduate, then you have to go and beg.
你去上大学，好好学习，然后毕业之后，你要去找工作的时候，你要乞讨。
Oh, my dear sir, please give me a job. I will be a good dog for you.
哦、oh, ，我亲爱的先生，给我一份工作吧，我会成为你的一条好狗的。
And when people come to see you and disturb you, I will chase them away.
然后，如果有人要来见你，然后就是给你干扰的话，我会把他们赶走。
I won't let them disturb you.
我不会让他们来干扰你。
just like the dogs, right?
Like 就像狗一样。
You go someplace and they've got the dog will bark. Why are you coming here? I'm here. You go away.
就像有的时候你去一个地方，那里有一条狗，然后狗就会冲你拼命的汪汪叫。你为什么要来这里？你赶紧走开。
And then camels.
骆驼。
People like to enjoy the thorny results of their work.
人们喜欢享受他们工作的荆棘的成果。
They'll do a lot of sinful activities.
他们会做很多的罪恶活动。
So it's like the camel eating thorns.
就像是骆驼在吃荆棘一样。
Tasting their own blood.
在品尝他们自己的鲜血。
And as is just a beast of burden carrying a heavy load to eat grass.
而驴呢，他们就是只是为了吃一口青草而承载着很多的重负。
So, people in the Kali Yuga, the Grihamedis are in this category. They're all like that: hogs, dogs, camels, and asses.
所以在卡利优格，人们就像是这些动物一样，他们好比是猪，好比是狗，好比是骆驼，好比是驴。
They never do any pious activities.
他们从来不会做任何虔诚的活动。
They never give charity.
他们从来不会给出布施。
They never bring guests to their home.
他们从来不会带任何的客人到自己的家里来。
They never come and bow their head before the deity.
他们从来不会在神像的面前顶拜。
So this is the Grihamedi.
这些都是 Grihamedi.
They're stuck in the wheel of birth and death.
他们卡在生死之轮之中。
So Sukadeva Goswami wants Maharaj Parikshit.To understand how lucky he is to get away from that life.
Shukadev Goswami 就在告诉 Maharaj Parikshit, 他能够摆脱这种生活是多么幸运啊！
We should also think we are very lucky to get away from that kind of association.
我们也应该认识到自己摆脱了这种类型的涟漪是多么幸运啊！
That we somehow, by some good fortune, we've been able to be here.In the holy dham and spend so much time in the association of the devotees.
我们也应该想到，我们能够在这个神圣的达姆过这么长的时间，待这么久，而且能够跟奉献者们一起联谊，是多么幸运的一件事情。
There should be a change in our hearts.
在我们的内心之中应该有所改变。
That we've been here in this holy dham for a prolonged.For quite a long time.
我们在神圣的 Tom 已经待了相当长的时间。
We should be experiencing the change in the heart.
我们应该能够体验到内心的改变。
That our hearts becoming cleaner.
我们的内心会变得更加的洁净。
We're getting rid of a lot of dirt from the heart.
我们会摆脱内心之中很多的肮脏的东西。
We're starting to see.More the nature of the material world.
我们会越来越多地看到这个物质世界的本性。
And we are less attracted to enjoy the material world.
而且我们会更少地受到去享受物质世界的吸引。
We are feeling more drawn to chanting the holy name.
我们感觉更受到吸引去唱诵圣名。
And we are taking pleasure.In being with the devotees.
而且我们跟奉献者们一起觉得会非常的快乐。
These symptoms are signs of the change of heart.
这些征兆便是内心改变的一些表现。
If our heart is not changing,
如果我们的内心没有改变，
then our heart must be like steel.
那我们的内心一定是像钢一样。
But I hope your hearts are not like steel.
我希望你们的心不要像钢一样。
Right, we want to have the soft heart.
我们想要得到柔软的内心。
We want to open the heart.
我们想打开我们的内心。
We want to see Krishna nicely in the heart.
我们想好好的看到 Krishna 在我们的心中。
Then we can taste the nectar of the holy name.
那样我们便可以品尝到圣名的味道，圣名的甘露。
We can experience the bliss of Krishna consciousness.
然后我们便可以体验到 Krishna 知觉的喜乐。
If you're not feeling any bliss, then you're not in Krishna consciousness.
如果你没有感觉到任何喜乐的话，那你就不在 Krishna 知觉之中。
So, we should lament. Oh, I'm
那样我们应该悲叹，哦，我太不幸了。
Why am I not feeling the bliss of Krishna consciousness?
为什么我没有感觉到 Krishna 知觉的喜乐呢？
Yamaraj must be punishing us.
Yamaraj 一定是在惩罚我们。
Because of all of our sinful activities in the past.
是由于我们过往所有那些罪恶的活动。
Therefore, we are not tasting the nectar.
所以我们没有品味到甘露。
But keep trying.And one day it will happen.
但是努力尝试终有一天会发生的。
One day the heart will open, it will blossom, and we'll experience that change of heart.
终于有一天，你的心扉会打开，然后你会体验到那种内心的改变。
We'll feel that love for Krishna.
然后我们会感觉到对 Krishna 的爱。
We'll feel the desire to want to go back to Godhead.
我们会感受到想去回归守神的愿望。
I'm sure as soon as you go back home, you'll very quickly want to go back to Godhead.
我确信一旦你们回家之后，就会很想回归守神。
You will appreciate how much fortunate we were to be in this holy dhamma.
你们会非常的欣赏我们在神圣的 dhamma 是多么幸运的一件事情。
Okay, are there any questions?
好吧，有什么问题吗？
Charachitra
Madhaji.
Guru Maharaj,
I'm very grateful unto you. Thank you for giving us transcendental knowledge from Srimad Bhagavatam. I'm feeling greatly enlightened and purified.My question is, since Maharaj Parikshit is such a great person and he is the grandson of Arjuna, how can he ask such a question like, what is the duty of a man who is going to die?Is that because he wants to raise up this question for us?
Well, also you have to understand there were many other people there and they were having different opinions about what one should do to actually prepare for death.
你要明白到在场的还有很多其他的人，他们也需要了解到为了准备死亡的话应该有什么样，应该做些什么。
Some were suggesting, you know, you should meditate on the impersonal Brahman.
因为他们的意见不一样，有的人说你应该去冥想非人格的布拉曼。
Some were saying you should do pious activity, give a lot of charity.
有的人说你应该做虔诚活动，做大量的布施。
Some were saying do a big yagya, satisfy the Supreme Lord.
有的人说你应该举行一场很大的祭祀来满足至尊主。
There are so many different opinions.
有很多不同的意见。
So Maharaj Parikshit wants to hear from the devotee.
Maharaj Parikshit, 他想从奉献者那里聆听。
Because he's a devotee.
因为他是一个奉献者。
And Sukadeva Goswami was also a devotee.
而 Sukadeva Goswami 也是一位奉献者。
So the two of them together means the talks will be about Krishna.
他们两个人在一起，这就意味着谈论的主题是 Krishna.
Maharaj Parikshit desires to hear about Krishna.
Maharaj Parikshit, 他的愿望是聆听 Krishna.
But he doesn't want to immediately just jump to the tent to hearing about Krishna's confidential pastimes.
但是他并不想一下子就跳到去聆听 Krishna 机密的逍遥时光上。
But it's important to appreciate all of Krishna's pastimes.
重要的是要欣赏到 Krishna 的所有的逍遥时光。
And Krishna's creation, what is called Srishti Tattva,means the creation, that is also Krishna's pastime.
Krishna 的创造，这个被称为是 Srishti Tattva, 这也是 Krishna 的逍遥时光之一。
So Maharaj Parikshit wants to hear about that.
因此 Maharaj Parikshit, 他非常想聆听这一点。
And he wants to hear about Krishna's different incarnations.
而且他想聆听关于 Krishna 的不同的化身。
He wants to hear about Krishna's different energies.
他想聆听关于 Krishna 的不同的能量。
How how they're acting, what their functions are doing.
他们是怎么运作的？他们有什么功能？
So Maharaj Parikshit is very interested to hear all different aspects in relation to Krishna.
Maharaj Parikshit 想聆听所有跟 Krishna 有关的方方面面。
And we see how it's very progressive, as I was saying.
而且我们可以看到，正如我所提到的，这是一种循序渐进的过程。
In the second canto, it begins first of all, the first step in self-realization is talking about the Virata Rupa.
在第二篇的开篇，我们先谈到了自我觉悟的第一部分，那就是 Virata Rupa。
And then the second chapter is the Lord in the heart.
然后第二章是在内心的主 Paramatma。
And then the third chapter is about the Supreme Lord and devotional service.
而第三章是至尊主奉献服务。
So that's just there in the second canto, but when you hear about the Lord's other incarnations, we hear about the Lord, like Varaha, how he appears in the boar form and performs wonderful pastimes.
这是第二篇的内容，然后我们还可以看到，听到主的其他的化身，比如说 Varaha, 他也上演了非常奇妙的逍遥时光。
We hear about the Lord as Nrisingadev, half man, half lion.
我们听说主是 Nrisingadev, 半人半狮。
We hear about many different incarnations of the Lord, and it helps us to understand how the Lord has inconceivable potency.
我们可以听到主的很多其他的化身，从而了解到主具有不可思议的力量。
It's important for people to understand Krishna not as an ordinary person.
重要的是要让人们理解到 Krishna 并不是一个普通的人。
If we just jump to Krishna Lila, we'll be thinking, oh, Krishna, I'm also like Krishna, I can also do like Krishna.
如果我们一下子跳到 Krishna 的那些逍遥时光上去，我们就会认为啊，我也像 Krishna 一样，我也可以做到像 Krishna 的一样的事情。
And then when we hear Rasa Lila, we think, "Wow, yeah, great, oh, that's for me, oh boy."
然后我们一看到这个 Rasa Lila 就觉得，哇，天哪，这就是给我准备的，我也可以去做。
So you have to hear these things very carefully.
我们应该非常小心的去聆听这些东西。我们首先要净化自己。
That's why the Srimad Bhagavatam is spoken in the manner it is, that we will, by hearing about creation and the Lord's energies and avatars, we'll become more and more purified and we'll have more and more understanding of the Lord's inconceivable potency.
这是为什么我们在聆听 Srimad Bhagavatam 的时候应该循序渐进如其所如，这样我们要聆听到所有的这些不同的化身，然后呢还有创造，然后主的能量的运作，这样我们可以让自己得到净化。
So Sukadeva Goswami, just like when in Bhagavad Gita we see how Lord Krishna presented the Bhagavad Gita, he didn't immediately speak about Bhakti Yoga.
就像在巴格吉塔之中，主是怎么讲的巴格吉塔呢？他并没有立刻的提出 Bhakti Yoga。
He taught the yoga ladder.
他提到了瑜伽阶梯。
And then we heard about Karma Kanda, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Jnana Yoga, then Bhakti Yoga.
我们听到 Karma Kanda, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, 然后最后才听到这个Bhakti Yoga.
Then we can understand more what is Bhakti Yoga.
然后我们才能够理解到 Bhakti Yoga。到底是什么？我们更多的去了解 Bhakti Yoga。
So people need to hear also Srimad Bhagavatam step by step.
人们也应该一步一步循序渐进的去聆听 Srimad Bhagavatam。
Maharaj Parikshit is a great devotee, but he still wants to hear about all of Krishna's aspects.
Maharaj Parikshit 是一位伟大的奉献者，仍然他想聆听到 Krishna 有关的所有的方方面面。
People just simply hear about Krishna's confidential pastimes. It's not good.
如果人们只是聆听 Krishna 机密的逍遥时光，那是不是一件好事？
They will not understand.
他们将不会理解。
They have the wrong idea.
他们会得到错误的概念。
So it's very important that they hear Krishna's create, how Krishna creates, and how Krishna has.Different incarnations, inconceivable forms, so many wonderful pastimes, and more they come to understand the inconceivable potency.
因此，非常重要的是，人们应该聆听 Krishna 有很多的化身，然后 Krishna 是如何进行创造 ，Krishna 有不同的能量，逐渐的，他们可以明白到 Krishna 具有不可思议的能量。
plane fell in other planets, the people they have subtle bodies. And my question is, what is the meaning of having a subtle body? Because I quite don't understand much. Means when we hear about the demigods and inhabitants of other planets, they look like having a normal body like we have. Means they also eating, sleeping, they fighting, they dying, they getting all those things. Or maybe not. That's why I want to clarify this. I also don't know what is the difference of a ghost body and a subtle body in another planet. There is any advantage actually to have a subtle body. If you can maybe explain a little bit, because I understand that this ghost body is only in this planet. But other planets, like heavenly planets, or even lower planets, they have in a subtle body, not gross body, but what is the difference? I don't know.
Marichi Prabhu 的问题是 ，Maharaj， 您讲到了在其他的星球上有精微的躯体，那这个精微的躯体到底是什么一种情况？因为我们理解到，因为看起来好像有时候半身人他们的这个躯体跟我们是一样的，然后他们也会吃东西，也会睡觉，他们也会打仗，可能他们不会变老，但是他们也会死去，而且可能只有在我们这个星球上才有粗糙的躯体，在其他的星球上，高等星球他们有精微的躯体，在低等星球上应该他们也有比我们更好的一个躯体，他们也是精微的躯体。拥有精微的躯体有什么样的好处呢？而且我还想更多的了解一下鬼魂的躯体，就是这些方面能不能给我们讲一讲。
But we don't get a lot of information about these things.
关于这些东西呢，我们没有得到很多的信息。
But you can read Brihad Bhagavat Amrita, and we read about Gop Kumar, how he travels through the different planets in the universe.
但是我们可以去读 Brihad Bhagavat Amrita， 其中 Gopal Kumar 他旅行到了不同的星球。
How he went first to Swarga. Well, he was here on Earth, and then different places, and then somehow he got the chance to go to Swarga Loka, to heaven, and then from heaven he went on to the Mahaloka, and then Jana Loka, Tapaloka, Satya Loka.
他本来是在地球上，后来他去了天堂星球，去了 Swarga Loka， 后来他又得到了机会去了 Mahaloka, Jana Loka, Satya Loka.
So it doesn't really tell us a lot about the power of having the subtle body, but we're told how he travels there and how he meets people there and how they're doing different activities, like I described, that some place Mahaloka they're doing big yagyas, and in Tapaloka they're meditating.
并没有告诉我们很多关于这种精微躯体的力量，我们只知道他去旅行去了不同的地方，我们提到过在 Mahaloka 大家在做祭祀，在 Tapaloka 大家在冥想。
And then Satya Loka, the top of the universe, and it's the most subtle body. The body's become really subtle there when you get up to Brahma Loka.
在 Satya Loka 也就是宇宙的顶部，这个地方大家的躯体非常的精微，就是 Brahma 住在那里。
What is the benefit of having a subtle body? Well, benefit is you don't have to suffer all the miseries which the material body goes through.
拥有一个精微的躯体有什么样的好处呢？如果你要是拥有精微的躯体，你就不用去经历那些这个粗糙的物质躯体所遭受的那些痛苦了。
You know, the material body is subject to so many miseries.
我们知道物质躯体受制于很多的痛苦。
But even in the higher planets also, there are some miseries. There are some difficulties there.
但是即使是在高等星球，在那个地方也有痛苦，也有一些难处。
Just like in the heavenly planets, when Gop Kumar went to heaven, he saw there was always, there was some envy there. You know, that the some feelings of the demons, that the demons are going to come and attack them. So they have to worry about that. The demigods always worry about the demons coming to attack them. And then they feel some envy to who's the ruler, who's in charge, Indra's in charge.
就像在天堂星球 Gopakumar 看到那个地方的人们，他们有一些嫉妒的情感，因为半神人们总是在担心恶魔们会来攻击，然后谁是统治者，是因着是统治吗？然后就是说他们会互相的打仗，担心自己的地位被剥夺。
So some feeling bit, a little bit not so harmonious feelings, you know.
有一些不和谐的情感。
And then go up to the higher planets and subtle bodies, doing meditation, tapaloka, to sit and meditate. So there's no activity there, but they're simply absorbed. They're thinking of the Lord.But they don't actually do service. They just sit and think of the Lord.
去高等的星球，他们有精微的躯体，比如说在 Tapaloka， 他们在冥想，坐在那儿什么都不做，他们只是想着主，并没有做任何的服务给主。
So you don't need the gross body. You're not using it.
你其实不需要一个精微的躯体，你也用不上。你不需要一个粗糙的躯体，用不上。
No, you just sit and meditate. You don't have bodily needs to take care of.
因为你只是坐在那儿去冥想的话，你不需要去照顾躯体的需求。
They don't have to worry about eating and sleeping.
他们并不需要去担心吃东西和睡觉。
Because they're just meditating all the time.
因为他们只是一直在冥想。
They're just in samadhi.
他们处在 samadhi 之中。
We don't really get a lot of information about.Exactly how is the existence, but we do keep our existence. Although we're subtle, we do keep our individuality. And we have that form, somehow we have a, and somehow there are relationships there. The Gopakumar went there and they met him and the, you know, he went, so his form actually became subtle as he went to these higher planets and he was meeting with them and they were welcoming him and telling him what they're doing there and everything.
因为在那个地方有一个精微的躯体，就像戈帕库马尔他去了那样的地方，他也有一个精微的躯体，但是精微的躯体之中大家有自己的个体的存在，这种存在性还是有的，而他们有不同的关系，而且大家会告诉戈帕库马尔他们在做什么，跟他有这种关联。
So there's individual relationships.
因此存在着个体的关系。
So we read about the demigods, even they have their wives.
我们读到半神人，他们甚至是有妻子的。
They travel,
他们旅行。
They go different places to enjoy Sankirtan festivals.
他们去不同的地方享受 Sankirtan 的节日。
They just don't come here in the Kali Yuga.
只是在 Kali Yuga， 他们不会来这里而已。
But other times they would come.
其他的时候他们会来。
Yeah, Mathura.
刚刚古鲁，我有一个问题，就是圣舒卡和格斯瓦米，他是伟大的灵魂，像我们这种普通的灵魂，也可以通过自我满足，就是达到快乐吗？就是我们需要通过这种物质的满足达到快乐，就是我们也可以。
Shukadeva Goswami is a great soul. He can find pleasure.By self-realization in himself. But what about us as ordinary living entities? How can we get pleasure from ourselves? We can only get pleasure from material aspects.
Well, we have to awaken the taste for hearing about Krishna.
我们必须要唤醒我们去聆听 Krishna 的品味。
That takes some practice.
这是需要一些练习的。
Chant the holy name.
我们要念诵圣名。
We have to purify ourselves.
我们要净化自己。
As I said, our soul is covered.
正如我提到的，我们的灵魂被覆盖了。
Some of us are more covered.
我们有一些人覆盖的程度更厉害。
Just like winter time, you know, the blanket, you put more blankets, you cover yourself up because it gets colder.
就像是冬天，我们会用更多的毯子来覆盖我们自己，是因为越来越冷。
Same way, our soul is covered.By so many material attachments and things we identify with.
同样呢，我们这个灵魂也被很多的东西所覆盖，我们认同于很多的东西。
But if we do devotional service, we go through the devotional set, the different practices, hearing and chanting, going to bathe in the holy rivers, or bathing in the sound vibrations of the holy name.Do kirtan, see the deities, eat prasadam, all of these things, they help to purify us and take the covering off.
但是如果我们去修习奉献服务的这些方面，我们去唱诵圣名，我们去圣河里沐浴，或者是我们沐浴在圣名的音阵之中，我们去参与 Kirtan， 我们荣耀 Prasadam， 这样我们便可以让自己得到净化。
And take the coverings off, you experience the bliss of the soul.
当我们通过净化把自己的覆盖拿掉之后，你便可以体验到灵魂的喜悦。
We said Krishna consciousness is in everyone, but it has to be awakened.
我们说 Krishna 知觉存在于每个人的身上，但是这个必须被唤醒。
Just like now, it's a bit colder in the morning, and you know, I don't want to wake up, you know.
就像现在早上有点冷，然后你就觉得，哦，我可不想起床。
And somebody comes and says, "Come on, Prabhu, you've got to go to school today. You've got to."
有人来叫你，哎 ，Prabhu， 今天你得上学，你就觉得，哦。
Right, yeah. So.Like that, we need to be reminded, you know, we need to be encouraged in our spiritual practice. We need to endeavor, we need to practice and hear for a long time, and gradually we'll get rid of these coverings and we will awaken the taste.
这样呢，我们在自己的灵性修习之中是需要不断的有人来提醒我们、鼓励我们的。通过这样不断的去练习，我们就可以去重新唤醒我们的品味。
Taste is in us, but we have to get rid of all this contamination from the heart.
品味已经在我们之内，但是我们应该去首先消除内心之中所有的这些污染。
我想问一下，在中国现在有很多瑜伽馆，特别比如说慧兰瑜伽，他们也唱诵这个尼泰戈尔哈利布，他们唱诵了很多，这个是不是会净化他们，甚至帮他们达到去到主柴坦那样的？
In China, there are many yoga studios. One famous one is led by Hui Lan, and she also teaches people to chant Nitaigor Haribo. They chant a lot. Does that mean they would also lead people to Lord Chaitanya?
Well, they also chant Hare Krishna.
他们也唱诵 Hare Krishna.
They also chant Japa.
他们也唱诵 Japa.
But when they do Kirtan, they don't chant Hare Krishna.
但是当他们做 Kirtan 的时候，他们不去唱诵 Hare Krishna.
So they're special.
他们很特殊。
Yeah, they're connected to Prabhupada.
他们跟 Prabhupada 也有关系。
They read Prabhupada's books.
他们阅读 Prabhupada 的书。
So, yeah, they're connected to Lord Chaitanya.
是的，他们跟主柴坦也是有关联的。
Yes, Mili?
Guru Maharaj, I have a question. It's about as a pure devotee, and what's the stronger emotion?They want to go back to Goloka Vrindavan, or they want to do external devotional service for Krishna. Which one is
who?
The pure devotee.
Oh.
As a pure devotee, which one is the most stronger emotion?
Which one is?
Which emotion is most stronger?They want to go back to Goloka Vrindavan or they want to do external service for Krishna. If they want to do external devotional service for Krishna, will they go back to material world again and continue preaching?
美玲的问题是说，对于纯粹奉献者而言，他们有两种情感，哪种情感更强烈？他们是想回灵性世界去呢，还是说不断的去服务 Krishna？ 如果是不断的服务 Krishna， 他们可能是不是就还得回到这个物质世界里来
？I don't think there's a difference.
我不觉得有一个区别。
If they stay here and do devotional service, that's back to Godhead.
那么如果他们待在这儿做奉献服务，这个也是一种回归守身。
For the pure devotees, there's no material world.
对于纯粹奉献者而言，没有物质世界可言，这就是灵性世界。
So pure devotees, they don't make a distinction.
纯粹奉献者不做这样的区分。
Wherever they are, they're going to serve Krishna.
无论他们身处何处，他们都会去服务 Krishna.
Prabhupada was in New York. He said, I'm in Vrindavan.
Prabhupada 在纽约，他说我在 Vrindavan。
I'm always thinking of Krishna.
我总是在想着 Krishna。
So it's not a question of being in the material world and going back to Godhead. This is the spiritual world if we're Krishna conscious.
所以说不存在这种说待在物质世界还要回灵性世界的问题。这个对于纯粹奉献者而言就已经是灵性世界了。如果你去服务 Krishna 的话。 So the correct understanding means we should purely serve Krishna instead of always thinking going back to Goloka Vrindavan.
Yes.
是的。
That's right.
这是正确的。
Yes.
Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj. 我还接着我提那个问题，就是我们聆听学习圣贤波德瓦坛，了解至尊主的创造，了解 Krishna 的各种宇宙形体，还有了解至尊主奎师那的这个赋予，了解他的美妙的逍遥时光，都是目的是不是都是为了了解了解主奎师那。但是从那个博迦梵歌第七章的第三十节说，这个在千千万万怎么说了呢，在千千万万的就是追求美好的，只有啊，
追求
对，在千千万万追求完美的人中，只有一个人，在千千万万人中，只有一个人能达到完追求达到完美。然后在那些达到完美的人，几乎没有一个人认识我。那就是我们这些不完美的人，可能是没有认识至尊主，那我们还能投入理性世界吗？还能达到纯粹吗？
Her question is, we are studying Srimad Bhagavatam, we are learning all aspects of Krishna, Krishna's creation, Krishna's different vibhuti opulences, etc. But in Bhagavad Gita 7.3, it is mentioned among thousands of people who want to achieve perfection, maybe only one achieved that perfection. But among thousands of people who have already achieved perfection, hardly there's one who understand me. But we are all imperfect. So how can we have hope we can understand Krishna and achieve the highest perfection?
Well, you should understand that you're very fortunate because you have a connection with Srila Prabhupada and with the disciplic succession.
首先你应该明白到你自己是非常幸运的，因为你跟 Srila Prabhupada 有一个连接，所以你就跟这个使徒传系有一个连接。
And there's only one among millions of people who are connected to that disciplic succession.
可能在数百万人之中，只有一个人能够跟使徒传系有连接。
And so That is very fortunate that we got somehow we caught hold of the mercy of that great devotee.
所以我们非常的幸运，我们能够抓住这样一位伟大的奉献者。
So yes, very rare.
非常罕见。
And somehow we got what was very rare.
但是无论如何，我们得到了，虽然非常罕见。
So you just have to hold on to Srila Prabhupada.
你只要紧紧抓住 Srila Prabhupada 就可以。
And Srila Prabhupada, with the help of the disciplic succession, will take you back to Godhead.
而 Srila Prabhupada 连同使徒传系的仁慈，就会带你回到守神那里。
Well,
Guru Maharaj, there is question from online. Tejas Prabhu is asking, Hare Krishna, my humble obeisances to spiritual master and devotees. So I want to promote book distribution. I want to make a competition of reading Bhagavad Gita. And I want to invite some social celebrities as the committee member. Is that possible? I want to make these social celebrities as our supporters.我先读一下 Tejas Prabhu 的问题，他说 Hare Krishna 顶拜灵性导师和奉献者，为了更好的去推书，想办个读博家放歌演讲比赛，请些名人做评委，可行吗？让这些名人作为我们的支持者。
Yes, we bless you, whatever you do.
是的，无论你做什么，我们祝福你。
May you spread Krishna consciousness.
愿你传播 Krishna 知觉。
May Krishna bless you.
愿 Krishna 祝福你。
Srila Prabhupada ki
jai.
We're back to Vrinda.
Jai.
Oh, go back. For the flowers.
She wants to ask a question.
就说是如果我们成为了一个纯粹的奉献者，是不是就是我们 也可能我们就无所谓回去格罗卡，或者是无所谓在什么地方，或者说是不是克里斯那说，如果这个出车的奉献者他想回去就让他回去，想留在这儿就让他留在这儿，或者说就我们就是听克里斯那的，克里斯那让我们留在这儿就留在这儿，让我们回去就回去，是不是这样的？
She wants to know her position. Once if we become a pure devotee, where we are going to stay. Maybe we stay in any place is as good as the spiritual world, or we stay as Krishna ordered us to stay. Or maybe we can, at any time, whenever we want to go back, we go back to the spiritual world. Whenever we want to, we stay in the material world. What is our position when we become pure devotees?
Well, when you become a pure devotee, you know.
等你成了纯粹奉献者，你就知道了。
Just become a pure devotee.
你就先成为纯粹奉献者吧。
Don't worry about all.
别担心其他的那些了。Hare Krishna.
就是给我祝福。我就希望姑姑
祝福，哎，姑姑马上只给你祝福了，还祝福。
谢谢姑姑，我就想，
还有会师呢，结束了。接着咱们做 kirtan。
Thank you. Thank you. Oh. Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Sabía si cámara. Sabía si cámara.